Hello students, welcome back to our YouTube channel Empower Education. I am your chemistry teacher and your guide Tejashni. Students, do you know that carbon is the fourth most abundant element in the nature? Due to its unique properties, it can find many compounds in nature. Yes, that is tetravalency and catenation property. In today's video session, we are going to discuss about tetravalency of carbon. So student, let's start. What we are going to learn in today's video session? We are going to learn about the definition of valency. We are going to learn about valence electrons, how to find valency of an element, and yes, tetravalency of carbon. So let's start with the definition of valency. So students, valency is nothing but combining capacity of an atom. Some atoms like to donate or gain electrons while others share them to combine with another atom. So yes, in simple language you can say that combining power or combining capacity is known as valency. Now let's discuss about what are valence electrons. So students, electrons which are present in the outermost shell of an atom are known as valence electrons. Students, do you know about the different shells and their electron capacity? So let's discuss. There are shells like you can see here, K shell, L shell, M shell and N shell. So K shell has capacity of 2 electrons, L shell has capacity of 8 electrons, M shell has capacity of 18 electrons, while N shell has capacity of 32 electrons. So here in this particular diagram you can see this shell, which is the outermost shell, okay, that is known as valence shell, and electrons which are present in that particular shell that are known as valence electrons. So is it simple for you students? So that electrons which are present in the outermost orbit of an element that are known as valence electrons. So now let's discuss about how to find valency of an element. Okay, so let's start. Now students, you know about what is valency, which is the combining capacity. Okay, valence electrons, those electrons which are present in the outermost orbit or outermost shell that are known as valence electron. Then how to find valency of a particular element? There are different ways to find the capacity, to find the valency of an element. So what are those ways? Let's discuss. First one is octet rule. So you know that noble gases have 8 electrons in their outermost orbit and that's why they are stable in nature. But there are many other atoms which are not contain 8 electrons in their outermost shell. That's why they are unstable in nature. And to find or to gain the stability, what they do? Simply, they share electrons with each other and with that sharing, they will stable in the nature. So that is the octet rule. Okay, you have learned about that. So here is one example which is given to you. That is the first way with the help of octet rule. And second one with the help of periodic table. So students, you know that periodic table first column which has metal, its valency is +1. While the elements from 18 group, its valency is 0 and they are inert. So this is the one way. Now you have one example on your screen. You can see that how to find valency of an element. Here is the question for you. Calculate the valency of phosphorus in phosphorus pentoxide, that is P2O5, which is given on your screen. You can see here. P2O5, that is phosphorus pentoxide. Now, how to find valency of phosphorus? You have to find valency of phosphorus in that particular compound, that is phosphorus pentoxide. Now, you can see how to find the valency of that particular phosphorus in the problem. Now, you see, in P2O5, two atoms of phosphorus are combined with 5 atoms of oxygen, as you can see, right? Now, simply you have to do 5 atoms of oxygen into 2 atoms of phosphorus, which is equal to 10. So, these are 10 valency units, students. Therefore, 1 atom of phosphorus will have 10 divided by 2. Why 2? Because here number of phosphorus atom are 2. So, that's why you have to simply divide that 2 with 10 valence unit. And what will you get? Here, 5. So, in this way, valency of phosphorus in phosphorus pentoxide is 5. This is a simple example for you students. You can find out many other examples also. Okay? Agar aapko aise aur example chahiye with explanation, you can drop a message in the comment box. Okay? So, this is the simple example, and with that example you can find out how to find valency of a particular element. First one, follow the octet rule. Second, periodic table, and with the help of chemical formula. So, this is one of the example that you can simply find out the valency of an element. Now, moving on to the next slide, we are going to discuss about tetravalency of carbon. On your screen, student, you can see here electronic configuration of carbon is given, and how we calculate electronic configuration, student? We find out electronic configuration with the help of atomic number. Yes, or carbon ka atomic number kya hai, student? That is 6. Now, how you can distribute that electrons, like 2 and 4. Here you can see 2 and 4. So, in the first shell of the carbon, there are 2 electrons, right? And in the outermost shell of carbon, there are 4 electrons. So, carbon has 4 valence electrons. As we have discussed about the definition of valency, we have discussed about what are valence electrons. The electrons which are present in the outermost orbit of an atom are known as valence electrons, students. So, my dear students, here in the outermost shell of carbon, there are 4 electrons. So, to attain stability for carbon atom particularly, we are going to discuss. Agar carbon ko stable hona hai, to usko kya karna padega? Usko 4 electrons share karne padenge, right? With carbon itself or with other elements. Okay. So, in this way, it can gain or it can attain stability in nature. And this property is known as tetravalency of carbon. So, you can see here one example given on your screen, that is methane. Carbon combines with hydrogen, with 4 hydrogen atoms, because it is tetravalent in nature, its valency is 4. That means it can find 4 bonding, right? 4 bonds with other atoms or with itself, carbon itself. So, here in methane, you can see carbon ne kya kiya hai? Hydrogen ke saath bonding ki hai, right? Yahan pe ek jo electron hai, wo carbon ka hai, aur ek jo hai, wo hydrogen ka hai. So, in this way, you can see here, single bond. Yes, carbon can also make double bond, triple bond. Aapko agar iski baare mein jankari chahiye, to aap mera jo carbon and its compound ka jo video hai, wo aap dekh sakte ho. Vahan pe aapko iski detail information milegi. Okay, so in simple language, you can say that carbon has 4 valence electrons, and with the 4 valence electron, it can so simply, students, carbon can find 4 bonds or can make 4 bonds with another element. So, this is tetravalency of carbon. this is the simple property and one of the important property of carbon. So student, what you have to remember, let's see, always remember what you have to remember always. Carbon is tetravalent, so it can combine with four other atoms of itself or atoms of other elements like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. Okay, so you have to remember this, and with the help of this property and catenation property, carbon can find large number of compounds in nature. Students, अगर आपको catenation property के बारे में और जानकारी चाहिए होगी तो please drop me message in the comment box. I will make sure कि मैं उस पर भी एक video बनाऊंगी. Okay? So I hope कि आज हमने जो पढ़ा है simple language में आपको वो जरूर समझा होगा. हमने tetravalency के बारे में आज पढ़ा है और valency, valence, electrons, इसके बारे में भी हमने आज जानकारी ली है. अगर आपको ये वीडियो मेरा अच्छा लगा तो डोंट फॉरगेट टू लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब. बट हियर सम क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू स्टूडेंट्स. सो व्हाट आर द क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू? हाउ मेनी मोर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स डज कार्बन नीड टू हैव अ फुल आउटर एनर्जी लेवल? सो दैट इज वन क्वेश्चन, ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग क्वेश्चन फॉर यू स्टूडेंट. एंड नेक्स्ट वन, नेम द एलिमेंट्स विच आर टेट्रावेलेंट. सो अगर ये आपको, इसके जवाब आपको आते हैं तो प्लीज ड्रॉप मी मैसेज इन द कमेंट बॉक्स. और मुझे फिर से आपको यही कहना है कि आपके मोटिव, आपके जो लाइकिंग है, आपका जो कमेंट है स्टूडेंट्स, आपके लाइक्स और आपके कमेंट्स हमें मोटिवेट करते हैं. सो डोंट फॉरगेट टू लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब टू अवर चैनल. थैंक यू.